In this video, we will see how we can perform the experiments virtually without having access to the real labs. For that, you have to type virtual labs in Google and all these links, they will open up. Go to the virtual labs, a site of virtual labs by Ministry of Human Resource and Development, it will open up. And these labs, they are created with an objective to provide a remote access to labs of various disciplines, labs in various disciplines of science and engineering to a variety of students at all levels, graduation, post-graduation, and even for the research scholars. And it covers a broad area. Here you can see electronics and communication, computer science and engineering, electrical engineering, mechanical engineering, chemical engineering, and many more such as physical sciences, chemical sciences. One can opt for any of these disciplines, such as if I go for physical sciences lab, then a whole list of labs ready for the use, you can find them here. Solid state physics virtual labs, these virtual English and communication labs, laser optics lab, and you can opt any of these labs in which you want to perform the experiment. For example, if I choose modern physics lab, then this page, it will come up with a list of experiments which can be done. Frank Hertz experiment, soldering, solar panel, photoelectric effect, determination of Planck's constant. You can choose for any of the experiment you want to do. Well, and after choosing the experiment, suppose I have opted for Planck's constant, this page, it will come up. It is having several icons. On the first, they have given a brief aim, apparatus, and a brief theory about the experiment, where you can get to know how the how this experiment is getting performed, from where we are getting the formula. This experiment is simply about the calculation of Planck's constant, which can be done by varying the voltage across any light source. For that, they have taken a power supply, one-way key, a rheostat, a digital milliammeter, digital voltmeter, and a rheostat, and most important, different known wavelength LEDs. Now, energy, it can be defined as E is equal to Hc by lambda, and also E is equal to Eb. By comparing both these expressions, we can get H is equal to E by C into lambda V. And hence, by varying the voltage across a light source, we can find the value of Planck's constant. On the next page, you can find the procedure for performing the experiment. Two types of procedures they are given. One is for simulation. That means if you are performing the experiment virtually without an access to the real lab. And second one is for the real lab. Here you can make the connections according to this circuit diagram. You have to make these connections, and then you have to note down the voltage across the LEDs using a voltmeter, and finally using that formula which I told you earlier, you can find the value of Planck's constant. This is the observation table. Here you have to write the color and the wavelength. Wavelength you know, because we are selecting known wavelength light source. New voltage you will find from the experiment. And finally, by multiplying these two factors, lambda into V, you can find the value of Planck's constant. For simulation, that is meant for virtual labs, they have already given the connections here. We will see how these experiments they can be performed virtually in the simulator section. For an access to the simulator section, you have to create an account on this site. Since I have already created, I am able to open it. You have to create account on this site first. So kindly do it first, and then according to the circuit diagram, you have to make the connection very easy. You have to select any key from where you want to make a connection, and you can do it like this. By doing all the connections, then you have to click insert key. Then you have to opt for a particular LED. Here I have taken red LED, and then by changing the voltage across the light source, you have to change the voltage till the LED it starts glowing. Now see if the light has started. Now you can make readings by changing this thing. So this is how you can perform the experiment using this virtual lab. Here another section of self evaluation is given with small questions related to LEDs, value of Planck's constant, and then their usage, they are given, they can read them. The small assignments, they are also given. These assignments, they will help you to get a better understanding about the experiment, and you can go through them. And finally, they have given some references for your further reading. You can check them here. And this is all about how these experiments, they can be performed both at the in the real laboratories and in the virtual laboratories. I hope you have understood it. So thanks.